the Western Cape, and not only the Western Cape, obviously beyond that as well, as we know that the Voice of the Cape is globally now, mashallah, a radio station serving humanity and serving the communities right around. Sheikh, being the Madrasa on Air, the face of Madrasa on Air you're seeing in front of you today, teaching us, teaching our children, relaying beautiful qisas to us, mashallah, stories. And this is just a little brief of Sheikh, mashallah. And also Sheikh, recital, beautiful. His qira'at is amazing, alhamdulillah. And Sheikh has studied also in Newcastle. I think Sheikh studied different riwayat as well, Sheikh. Alhamdulillah, Sheikh received ijazah in that as well. And we are just very honored today in Panorama that we, mashallah, can listen to Sheikh, you know, and Sheikh's title today is amazing. Zawrba, you online? Alhamdulillah, Sheikh's title today is the objective of Ramadan, you know, inshallah, which we think is important for us to know why Ramadan, inshallah, and then also the importance of the last 10 days that we will be entering tonight, inshallah, after Maghrib. May Allah accept from us and may Allah allow us to reach Laylatul Qadr. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. So without further ado, I'm giving over, mashallah, to one of the beautiful upcoming scholars in Cape Town. And may Allah ta'ala preserve him for many, many more years with us, inshallah, for the ummah to benefit from Sheikh, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum, falyatafaddal mashkura, Sheikh.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدنا وقائدنا قرة عيوننا وحبيب قلوبنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الحمد لله. All praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our sustainer, our controller, our giver, our creator, and our master. And blessing, peace, salutation upon our beloved Habib صلى الله عليه وسلم and all his companions and all those follow them till the day of Qiyamah. My dearest brothers and sisters in al-Islam, dearest scholars and ulama and elders, alhamdulillah, we begin by praising and thanking Allah for the ni'mah of Islam. We praise and thank Allah for this great ni'mah, great favor upon us. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We praise and thank Allah for the ni'mah of Quran, and we praise and thank Allah, we are the blessed ummah. We are the ummah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we praise and thank Allah for allowing us and giving us a chance to witness one extra Ramadan. The month of Ramadan, Shahru Ramadan, Shahru Tawbah, Shahru Ramadan, Shahru Rahmah, Shahru Ramadan, Shahru Al-Quran, Shahru Ramadan, Shahru Al-Ghufran, Shahru Ramadan, Shahru Al-Itqi Min Al-Niran, Shahru Ramadan, Shahrun Fihi Tukaffaru Sayyi'at Wayu'fu Allahu Ani Zallat Watustajabu Fihi Al-Du'at. The month of Ramadan, it is the month of mercy. The month of Ramadan, it is the month of forgiveness. The month of Ramadan, it is the month of Quran. The month of Ramadan, it is the month of repentance. The month of Ramadan, it is the month where Allah is prepared to free thousands of souls. وَذَلِكَ كُلَّ لَيْلَى. Each and every night, from the first night, from the first day of the month of Ramadan, Allah is offering us to free each and every night thousands of souls from Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. It is the month of acceptance. It is the month of generosity. It is the month of victory. Allah give victory to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions in the Battle of Badr. So the month of Ramadan, it is the month of victory. Allahu Akbar. But the question is, why Allah give us the month of Ramadan? And why Allah has allowed us to witness the next Ramadan? Talha radiallahu anhu, he was a great companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Talha, he says once, you know, two men, جَاءَ رَجُلَانِ مِنْ بَلِي إِلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فَأَسْلَمَ. Two men, they come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the same area, Bali. And both of them, they embraces Islam in the same day. But one of them, after embracing Islam, he was very hardworking. He used to make extra ibadah, used to stand in Salatul Layl, spend more time with the Quran, more time with the remembrance of Allah. If there is any help, he will help, he will offer help and so on. And one of them, he was average. He performed his 5 times daily salah, he read his portion of the Quran, and he do whatever he can do from the righteous deed he can. And the person who was the hardworking, it was a call to jihad, to strive in the path of Allah. And he went and he strived in the path of Allah Ta'ala, and he died as a shaheed. He died as a martyrdom. As we know, the reward of shaheed, subhanallah. Allah say, ضامن له الجنة. Allah guarantee for a person who died in the path of Allah as a shaheed that he will definitely enter Jannah. And Allah will forgive, يغفر للشهيد كل ذنبه. Allah will forgive all his sins, subhanallah. So one of them, he passed away and he died as a shaheed. And one of them, he lived one extra year after. And after that, he died as well. A normal death. Then Talha radiallahu anhu, he dreamt that he saw himself in the dream by the gate of Jannah. On his right side, the person who died as a shaheed. And on his left side, the person who died normal death. And he say, when the gate of Jannah open, a caller come. And he call a person who die 1 year later, a normal death. And I was expecting him to call a person who die as a shaheed. And I was amazed. Then the person who died 1 year later, he was called first to Jannah and he entered Jannah. Then a caller come again and he call a person who died as a shaheed. Then again he come, he say, oh Talha, it's not yet your time, because he was dreaming. Next morning, Talha radiallahu anhu, he narrate his story to his companions. And he was amazed also, the companions, he say, how? The person who died shaheed, he's supposed to enter Jannah first. Although both of them, they enter Jannah. Then they went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and they say, ya Rasulullah, Talha narrate to us this story. Then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, وَمِمَّا تَعْجَبُونَ. And why you are surprised? And why you are amazed? Didn't the person who died 1 year later, he witnessed one extra Ramadan? They say, yes. Didn't he make many sujood, bow and prostrate in front of Allah? Didn't he remember Allah more? He say, yes. He say, شَتَّانَ بَيْنَهُمَا. He said, you will never be able to compare the person who died as a shaheed and a person who witnessed one extra Ramadan. That indicates to us, my dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, when Allah give us one extra Ramadan, that means Allah want to purify us from the sin. That means Allah want to elevate our state in Jannah. That means Allah want to accept our dua. That means Allah want to purify our heart. That means Allah want us to repent to Him. That means Allah want us to reconnect with the Quran, reconnect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means Allah want us to improve our characters. That means Allah want us to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means Allah want us to unite with Allahu Akbar. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he warned us and he say, raghima anfu rajulin, raghima anfu rajulin, raghima anfu rajulin adraka ramadan wa lam yughfar lahu. Woe for that man, he is a bankrupt, he is a loser. Who he is, ya Rasulullah? Whomsoever Allah give him chance to witness one extra Ramadan, but his sin is not forgiven. Subhanallah, in one riwayah, فَانْسَلَخَ رَمَضَانْ وَلَمْ يُغْفُرْ لَهُ. And Ramadan end, but his sin is not forgiven. What is this means? Allah allow him to witness one extra Ramadan, but Allah didn't forgive his sin. That means he didn't take advantage of the month of Ramadan. His life in the month of Ramadan and outside the month of Ramadan is similar. There is no increasing. There is no avoiding the sin, the bad habit, the bad characteristic. There is no attachment to the Quran. And that's why Jabir radiallahu anhu, he defined to us the quality fast Allah wants from us. And he said, إِذَا صُمْتَ فَلْيَسُمْ سَمْعُكَ وَلْيَسُمْ بَصَرُكَ وَلْيَسُمْ لِسَانُكَ وَلْيَسُمْ قَلْبُكَ وَلَا يَكُنْ يَوْمُ صَوْمِكَ كَيَوْمَ فِطْرِكَ وَلْتَكُنْ عَلَيْكَ وَقَارٌ وَسَكِينَةٌ وَدَعَذَ الْجَارِ. Jabir, he say, when you fast, it's not only abstaining from your food and your drink. Because Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ وَالْجَهْلَ فَلَيْسَ لَهُ حَاجَةٌ فِي أَنْ يَدَعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, a person who does not leave all the useless speech, all the yani the wrongdoing, fighting and arguing and everything bad, that there is no point of him of leaving his food and his drink. And Jabir say, fasting means your eyes must fast, your ear must fast, your tongue must fast, your heart must fast, and your day during the month of Ramadan must not be like the day outside the month of Ramadan. وَلْيَكُنْ عَلَيْكَ وَقَارٌ وَسَكِينَةٌ. And when a person see you, he can see you are calm. You have the tranquility and peace on you, Allahu Akbar. And your eyes must fast at looking at whatever displeases Allah or looking at the defects of others. Your ear must fast from listening to all the useless conversation, the ghiba and the namima and everything, whatever it's considered as a sin, whatever you will be answerable about it, whatever it's harmful for others. And your tongue as well must fast from not speaking bad, not from swearing, and all the whatever displeases Allah. Rather you increase the remembrance of Allah. Rather you increase the recitation of the Quran. Rather you increase the listening to the Quran. May Allah give us tawfiq to understand. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Allah give us three mercy in the month of Ramadan. Although the entire month of Ramadan, each and every day is a mercy, it's a gift, it's a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. But from His Rahmah, Allah know our weaknesses. Allah say, من صام رمضان. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whomsoever fasts, observe the fasting of the month of Ramadan, all his past sin forgiven. The second one is, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Allah is offering us during the day and during the night. Allah say, just observe the fast and just do Salatul Qiyam and all your sin will be forgiven. And doesn't stop there. Allah say, we will also give you something special. من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. And whomsoever observe يعني the قيام of ليلة القدر, which will be in the last 10 days, the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, Allah say all his sin will be forgiven. Allahu Akbar. So the object of Ramadan, Allah want to forgive us and Allah want to accept our dua. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ say, ثلاث دعوات مستجابات. Three dua, Allah will never ever reject it. The dua of the parents to their children. That's why never ever make bad dua on your children, irrespective of how bad they are, irrespective of what they do. Subhanallah, always make dua for them, good dua for them. Because the dua of the parents is accepted. Allahu Akbar. And the second one, a traveler, his dua will never be rejected. And the third one, the fasting person, his dua will not be rejected. What is this means? Allah want to accept our dua. That means Allah want us to raise our hand and beg and ask from Allah. Whatever we ask, Allah says in the Quran, ud'uni astajib lakum. And call me and I will respond to your call. He said, man u'tiya arba'an, lam yumna' arba'an. And whomsoever Allah give him four, Hasan Basri rahimahullah say, Allah will not deprive him of four. من أعطي الدعاء لم يحرم الإجابة. Even to raise our hand, wallahi, even to raise our hand and ask from Allah, we need the help of Allah. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. No one will be able to raise his hand without the permission of Allah. And if we raise our hand, that means Allah want to accept from us. من أعطي الدعاء لم يحرم الإجابة. Whomsoever Allah give him the ability to raise his hand, that means Allah want to accept from him. And whomsoever Allah give him the ability to ask forgiveness, that means Allah want to forgive him. And whomsoever Allah give him the ability to repent to Allah, that means Allah want to accept his tawbah. And whomsoever Allah give him the ability to show gratitude and to be thankful, that means Allah want to bless him and increase for him. So Jama'at al-Muslimin, Alhamdulillah, whatever has gone from the month of Ramadan, ما ذهب فقد ذهب. Whatever has gone, if we were, alhamdulillah, striving to do good, may Allah accept from us. And may Allah make us among those whom Allah has freed them from Jahannam. And if we have shortcoming, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Aisha radiallahu anha say, كان إذا دخل العشر. Now it is the time to increase our speed. Now it is the time to maximize our righteous deed. Now it is the time to sacrifice our sleep. Now it is the time to increase everything, each and every act of worship, from nafil salah, from the recitation of the Quran, from listening to the Quran, from asking Allah's forgiveness, generosity and giving, dua and supplication, salatul qiyam, salatul taraweeh, salatul layl, and salatul tahajjud as well. It is the time now, because the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of mankind, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he will be the first person to enter Jannah. And he will receive maqam al-mahmood. And that's why after the adhan, وَبْعَثْهُ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا آتِ مُحَمَّدًا الْوَسِيلَ وَالْفَضِيلَ الْوَسِيلَ وَالْفَضِيلَ It's a place in Jannah. Allah created only for one person. And that will be our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَآتِ مُحَمَّدًا الْوَسِيلَةَ وَالْفَضِيلَ I will intercede for you on Judgment Day. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, whomsoever asks this for me, I will intercede for him. Subhanallah. The Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of mankind, the best of all the prophets, Aisha radiallahu anha, she say, كان إذا دخل العشر. Whenever the last 10 nights of Ramadan began, شد المئزر. What he do? He tighten his belt. What does this mean? This means that is an expression that is the time. This is the time where we can now take advantage of whatever remain. You know, like a racer person, a person who is racing, when he will increase the speed and when he will give everything, all the energy, when he's about to reach his destination, he will increase. And the Prophet ﷺ say, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالْخَوَاتِيمِ That our righteous deed will be concluded at the end. How we conclude it, subhanallah. If we didn't do good in the first 10 days, alhamdulillah, we make istighfar and we make dua that Allah accept whatever we do. And we continue. Now the second 10 days has passed. Now the most important nights, the best night ever. Imagine Allah is telling us, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. We have revealed the entire Quran in Laylatul Qadr. Then Allah say, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ Do you comprehend? Do you understand the value of this great secret power? Powerful night? Then Allah tell us, لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَارٍ For indeed, the night of Qadr and Laylatul Qadr, it's better than 1,000 months. Look at the rahmah of Allah. 1,000 months, 80 years, or 83 years. No one amongst us have the guarantee that he will reach that age. But Allah is prepared for one night. This is the karam and the jud of Allah. This is the generosity of Allah. Allah say, I appreciate. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا Allah say, I appreciate. Do you appreciate myself? Allah is giving us only one night. But Allah is prepared to give us 83 years of worship. Of ibadah, Allahu Akbar. And that's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Aisha radiallahu anha say, whenever the last 10 nights of Ramadan began, شد المئزر. He is to tighten his belt. And وَأَحْيَى اللَّيْلِ And he revived the night with ibadah. And from this hadith we understand, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never ever stand Salatul Layl from Isha to Fajr. That means revive the night with ibadah, with the dhikr of Allah, with the istighfar, with the dua, with the qiyam, and all the different types of righteous deed, Allahu Akbar. And not only this, وَأَحْيَى اللَّيْلَ وَأَيْقَظَ أَهْلَهُ And he used to ensure he awakened his family, that his family, his children, is part of the program. And alhamdulillah, each and every night, you know, there's a program here in the masjid. There is Salatul Layl. In fact, there is an i'tikaf, mashallah. What is the object of i'tikaf? Why the Prophet ﷺ, he used to make such an effort and ensure his family also take part of that. Imagine your family, your wife, your daughter, and your children attend Laylatul Qadr program. And all of you witness Laylatul Qadr. How many barakah and blessing Allah will place in our life? In the children's life, in our home, in our life, subhanallah. So the object of i'tikaf is to witness Laylatul Qadr. And that's why i'tikaf means inqita'. I'tikaf is not just come and sleep in the masjid and khalas. You sleep in the masjid and alhamdulillah. Beside this, sleeping in the masjid, alhamdulillah. It's a great blessing. You are the guest of Allah. But the object of i'tikaf means inqita'. You cut off from anything and everyone and everything, and you link your heart to Allah. Less phone, less WhatsApp, less Facebook. This is you cut off. You cut off from dunya and you can connect with Allah. You connect with akhirah. You connect with Jannah. Your concern is, in i'tikaf, our main concern is, how can my name be freed from Jahannam? And how can I witness Laylatul Qadr? And that's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he used to make i'tikaf and he used to encourage us, you know, search for Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 nights. It's not the last 10 nights, each and every odd night. And that's why the i'tikaf and the mu'takif, he must have a program in order for him to benefit. If he is not in the recitation of the Quran, he must be on the nafil salah. If he's not in the nafil salah, he must be in dua. If he's not in dua, in istighfar. If he's not in istighfar, he is qiyamul layl. If it's not, then rather he must be sleeping and resting. Allahu Akbar. And that's why Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make i'tikaf in order to witness Laylatul Qadr. Allahu Akbar. And that's why Aisha radiyallahu anha, she said, كَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يَجْتَهِدُ. يَجْتَهِدُ means he used to sacrifice and make extra effort, especially in the last 10 nights. مَا لَا يَجْتَهِدُ فِي غَيْرِهِ. He never ever make this extra effort in any other time but the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say, مَنْ حُرِمَهَا فَقَدْ حُرِمَ الْخَيْرَ كُلَّهُ. And whomsoever deprive himself from Laylatul Qadr, he has deprived himself from all goodness. Why? Because Allah say, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubaraka. Allah is telling us, this night is blessed. Tanazzalu al-malaika adad al-hasa. The angel will only come down in such a number. You know the pebble? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the angel will come down the numbers of the pebble or more or whatever in this earth. Can you imagine how many angels will be coming down? It's a great event. The rahmah of Allah, tranquility of Allah, acceptance, peace. Salamun hiya hatta matla'i al-fajr. And that's why the Habib Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, man hurimaha faqad hurima al-khayra kullah. And whomsoever يعني deprive himself from ليلة القدر, he has deprived himself from all goodness. For indeed he has deprived himself from 83 years of worship, of ibadah and salah and the remembrance of Allah. Allahu Akbar. A gift and a bargain. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to understand. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يعني accept from us, and let us make a strong intention that insha'Allah ta'ala, from now, I will start till the last day of the month of Ramadan. And not only this, I will continue after the month of Ramadan. Because Allah tell Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَعْبُدُ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, worship your Rabb, not only till the end of Ramadan, till certainty come to you. And that's why the month of Ramadan is an academy. And we learn, and we reconnect with many subjects, like sabr, subhanallah. Like gratitude, subhanallah. Like generosity. Like touching our heart with the Quran. Asking Allah to give us the love of the Quran. Listening to the Quran. The only time for all of us. Unless if a person is teaching the Quran, then he is the luckiest person. Because he's listening to one juz, the second juz, the third, the fourth. So he have the chance to listen to the entire Quran maybe in 1 month or 2 months. But all of us, wallahi, we don't have the ability, no one amongst us, including myself. He say, I listen to the Quran from the, you know, I put CD and I listen from Alif Lam Mim to Surah Nas. You listen to one surah, you're driving, then somebody call you, you stop and so on. But the only time where we are able to listen to the Quran from the beginning till the end, during Salat al-Tarawih. And each and every ayah, each and every ayah. That's why I tell the brothers and the sisters, even if you are exhausted, alhamdulillah, some of us, every one of us, his situation is different. Some of us go from 4 o'clock to work, come 8 o'clock. Even if you are exhausted and tired, do not leave the beautiful environment of the Quran. Sit on the chair and listen to the Quran. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud say, من سمع آية تتلى كانت له نورا يوم القيامة. that a person who listened to one verse, not one line, two line, one juz, or one quarter every night, whomsoever listened to one verse being recited, it will be for him nur on the day of Qiyamah. So the only time that we are able to read during the morning and to listen during the evening and to ask Allah to grant us the love where Allah is prepared to accept our dua, it is during the month of Ramadan. And that's why the month of Ramadan, it is the month of Quran. Listening to the Quran and reading the Quran, wallahi, listening to the Quran, it has its own effect on the person. Reading the Quran as well, and that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنِ. One is read the Quran, recite the Quran. Then Allah say, فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا. And one is to listen attentively. And what must be our intention each and every night when we stand in Salatul Taraweeh? We may not understand, but let us open our heart. And before we start Salatul Taraweeh, we say, Ya Allah, let each and every letter I listen to penetrate in my heart. Let that nur enter my heart. Because what is guidance? Which we will ask Allah each and every day in our salah. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Why we ask Allah each and every salah, guide us? We are making salah, but we're asking Allah, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Guide us to the straight path. When we define hidayah, hidayah, nurun yaqdhifuhu Allahu fi qalbi man yasha hatta yufarriq bayna al-haqq wal-batil wal-qabih wal-malih wat-tayyib wal-khabith. Allahu akbar. Guidance is a light. Allah places it in the heart whomsoever he wish, then he will be able to differ what is right, what is wrong, what is good, what is bad, what is pure and what is impure, what is rewarding and what is will be answerable about it. And that is the month of Ramadan. The object of the month of Ramadan, that we receive that nur, we receive that hidayah, and the moment that nur enter in our heart, we become muttaqeen. Allah say, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum as-siyam, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqoon. There is three objects of the month of Ramadan. One is that Allah want to forgive our sins. One is to achieve the taqwa. And one is to change our life, to change our heart, to change our manners, to change our thinking from dunya to akhirah. From this world, pleasing everyone and each and everyone, then pleasing Allah. From living our life according to what society wants, to ya ayyuha alladhina amanu dukhulu fi silmi kafa. All those who believe, enter Islam completely. That means live your life according to Allah. Not only in the masjid, whether you are in the masjid, outside the masjid. The way you do with your spouse, with the way you do with your family, the way you do with your employees, the way you do with your children, the way you do with your neighbor, whether he's Muslim or not. That is the object of the month of Ramadan. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. You may achieve the taqwa of Allah. And when the taqwa of Allah is in our heart, wallahi, whatever we say, it will be rewarding. Whatever we do, it will be rewarding. Why? Because taqwa means you are conscious of Allah. I don't want to harm so and so because Allah will ask me. Allah is watching me. That is muhasaba and muraqaba. You have halal food, all of us. If you go home now, you have halal food. You have drink, but you don't want to eat. This is taqwa. Allah is watching me. It's called muraqaba. And this is called muhasaba, accountability. So the month of Ramadan, it is the month of taqwa. It is the month of forgiveness, and it's the month of muhasaba. You know, what is my situation? Are we going to Allah or are we turning away from Allah? Are we going to build our Jannah or are we going back from Jannah? May Allah give us tawfiq to understand. And when we define taqwa, the simple definition of taqwa, imtithalu awamirillah wajtinabu nawahi. You strive. We strive to please and to protect each and every command of Allah. To be where Allah wants us to be. To do what Allah wants us to do. And to abstain from whatever displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sayyiduna Ali radiallahu anhu say, At-taqwa hiya al-khawfu min al-jaleel wal-ridha bil-qaleel wal-amalu bil-tanzeel wal-isti'adadu liyawm al-raheel. Sayyiduna Ali radiallahu anhu say, the taqwa is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To have the consciousness of Allah. To be aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the all-hearing. Allah is the all-seeing. You know, we link our heart with Allah, Al-Raqib, the watcher of every subject, Al-Sami', the all-hearing. That is the taqwa of Allah. Then he say, وَالْعَمَلُ بِالتَّنْزِيلِ, and to implement the Qur'an. You know, to listen to the Qur'an is one thing, to read the Qur'an is one thing, to ask Allah to grant us the love of the Qur'an is one thing, but more important than that, to adopt the akhlaq of the Qur'an. Like our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Aisha radiallahu anha, she was asked, he said, كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ, his character was the Qur'an. What is this means? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was an open book. When Allah said, be humble, he was humble. When Allah said, be generous, he was generous. When Allah said, be merciful, he was merciful. When Allah said, forgive, فَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا, he forgive. When Allah said, be patient, he was patient. When Allah said, be just, he was just. When Allah said, be firm, he was firm. When Allah said, be brave, he was courageous. May Allah give us tawfiq to understand. So the object of this, وَالْعَمَلُ بِالتَّنْزِيلِ, Sayyidina Ali say, to implement Qur'an, to live the Qur'an, to love the Qur'an, to recite the Qur'an, and to have the akhlaq of the Qur'an. And he say, وَالْإِسْتِعْدَادُ لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ, and to prepare yourself for the year after. Wallahi al-Azim, everyone you meet, he will say, Subhanallah. This Ramadan was the fast Ramadan. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned to us, one of the sign of our yataqarabu zaman. You know, a year will be like a month, and a month will be like a week will be like a day, and a day will be like an hour, and an hour will be like dirma, like a blink of an eye, subhanallah. So each and every day is taking us, yes, to the end of the month of Ramadan, but each and every day as well is taking us close to our destination, Allah. And that's why Hassan Basri rahimahullah say, إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ أَيَّامٌ مَعْدُودَاتٌ, O son of Adam, you are just a numbers of days. And each and every day pass from your life, you know, is taking you close to your destination. And we conclude with a beautiful, you know, statement of Abu Darda radiallahu anhu. We say, مَا نَدِمْتُ عَلَى شَيْءٍ نَدَمِي عَلَى يَوْمٍ غَرُبَتْ شَمْسُهُ نَقُصَ فِيهِ أَجَلِي وَلَمْ يَزْدَدْ فِيهِ عَمَلِي. He said, I never regret, Abu Darda radiallahu anhu, great companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, I never regret anything but a day which the sun set, it decreased my age and my righteous deed does not increase. Allahu Akbar. And that's why we treat each and every day as a muwaddi'. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, Sallu salat al-muwaddi'. Perform the salah of a person who will never come back. Imagine the doctor will tell you, you know, may Allah protect us from all the chronic illnesses. And I'm sorry, but sick, may Allah grant them shifa. Imagine that they discover that you have cancer. And they will tell you, you will live only for 10 days. By Allah, how do we spend the 10 days? We will ensure Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, we are in the masjid. We will ensure after the salam, we will take our adhkar. We will ensure that we recite the Quran. We will ensure that we attend each and every night Salatul Taraweeh. We will ensure that we give in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That must be our life, Allahu Akbar. We treat each and every day as it is the last day in our life. Because Abdullah ibn Umar say, if you witness the morning, there is no guarantee that you will witness the evening. And if you leave till the evening, there is no guarantee that you will witness the next morning. Wallahi, each and every day, wallahi, from the beginning of Ramadan till now, each and every day there is a janazah taking place. Different age, 83, 73, 63, 18. Sheikh Yusuf told me, there was a young man in Grassy Park, he had it all. He was strong. He was Hafiz al-Quran. He was very good rugby player. He was very good in his study. Subhanallah. His parents send him with a motorbike. When he come back, accident, khalas. He never come back. They send him to fetch something, and he never come back. Alhamdulillah, he was Hafiz al-Quran. He died in the month of Ramadan. But the point is, there is no guarantee, Allahu Akbar. And that's why Ibn al-Qayyim say, if the people who are in the graveyard now, they wish for one thing, they will tell Allah, let us witness one day of the month of Ramadan. They, alhamdulillah, we have completed 20 days from. And the best 10 nights is coming. So let us, inshallah ta'ala, take advantage of whatever remain, and remember, whatever passed, we cannot bring it back. But whatever is coming, we can take advantage of it, inshallah. May Allah accept from us. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. بارك الله فيكم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. We make dua, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu ta'ala freed us from Jahannam. Whomsoever seek, may Allah grant them shifa. Whomsoever, inshallah, traveling, may Allah take them safe and bring them safe. The mu'tamirin who are in Umrah, alhamdulillah, may Allah accept the Umrah, inshallah, and retain them safe. May Allah bless this community. May Allah bless Mawlana Wasim, inshallah, and the committee. And whomsoever is serving here, and those who served before also, may Allah reward them for everything, inshallah. May Allah unite this community and make it the center of the northern suburb, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
MashaAllah, we say Jazakumullah khairan to Sheikh Isa Sami for a thought-provoking, a short but very powerful reminder on the cusp, as we stand on the cusp of the last 10 days of Ramadan, a most solemn occasion, inshallah. Inshallah, we make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant Sheikh Isa a long life filled with good health, inshallah, that you may continue, and that Ilham Learning Center continues from strength to strength. MashaAllah, barakallahu fikum.